Hey, third graders. We wanted to share with you today a little art. What are we going to make?
We're going to make llamas.
A llama.
Or is it an alpaca?
Or an alpaca.
I don't know.
They can be easily done one way or another. So Lily found a picture that she wanted to use as an example and then create and make her own.
I had also found a picture and sketched this out. And so I'm going to use this kind of as my example because I wanted mine to look a little more alpaca-ish. And I'm just using a big book that we have to do it with.
Okay, Lily, what materials do we need to start with?
You can use a marker or a pencil,
mm-hmm.
Some paper, any kind of paper.
If you're going to paint, use one that's a little bit of a harder cardstock or a watercolor paper or something like that. Okay?
And then, another one is colors.
Yes, colors, paint, whatever you want to use for it. And we're going to start by drawing the basic shapes that you see here. In a llama, you can see almost like there's a big rectangle, or you can call it a big long oval. So you start with a long oval and then you can break it up into a smaller oval. These are kind of ovalish shapes as well. And you can build into that. Do you guys notice the different shapes there? Lily, what would you like to add? Not everybody likes to start with the basic shapes either.
Not everybody. And another thing you could do is draw the neck. Or you could start with the head, and the head is kind of like a peanut shape.
So we'll see how it goes in at the cheeks and it goes out like a peanut. Is that what you mean?
Yes.
All right.
So you would start with the neck if you don't want to do basic shapes, and then you would kind of do like a U shape.
And you sketch lightly first. It's easier to erase. Don't get frustrated. You can always erase and start over as many times as you want. So we just kind of slowly get our basic outlines, our basic shapes going on. Now, an alpaca is a little fluffier than a llama, generally. So you can add your fluff if you want it. And as you're drawing, just work around the whole picture. Don't just focus on one part because then things get a little lopsided. And kind of figure about, you know, how big you want the face.
Bagel cheese.
You look at the dimensions of where the eyes would go, the nose and mouth. Sometimes you can use use your fingers to measure things out. You can use
a ruler
to measure things out if you want to, or you can just eyeball it.
That's good. You can also add things on its head like flowers or some detail, pom-poms, whatever you want.
Now, llamas and alpacas' eyes are really wide set, which seems kind of funny maybe to some, but they kind of go over. So this looks kind of funny right now, doesn't it? Actually, right now it looks a little bit more like a donkey. But don't get discouraged. Sometimes as you're drawing,
you gotta finish it.
Yeah, as you're drawing, you might think it's kind of the not greatest thing, even through the process. And then the closer you get to the end, you start seeing it come together. So we've got circles for the eyes.
And the ears are like bananas.
Yeah, an oval for the head, a long maybe rectangle for the neck. And then, yeah, kind of like a banana almost. The ears come
half
up
of a
and
banana.
Out. Yep. And then at the top of the nose, so the nose you have kind of almost a circle-ish space for the nose and mouth, okay? Near the top, it's almost like a little M you do, kind of, or like if you ever draw birds in the sky kind of shape. To do the little nose detail, you can see it on this also, the little nose details. Maybe that doesn't show up really good. There's kind of an M shape here, and then you kind of mimic that on the underside. So far mine definitely looks a little bit more like a donkey.
Right now, that literally kind of looks like a fat heart.
A fat heart, like the top of a fat heart?
Yep.
Okay.
It's an interesting one. Right now, mine looks like something with no eyes blowing a bubble gum.
Something with no eyes blowing a bubble gum. Let me see that.
It looks like a bubble gum.
Oh, hey, yeah, that's coming together. Something with no eyes blowing a bubble gum. All right.
I have no idea.
Cookie. Cookie.
You can eat. So, you see the circle of your nose? Or shall I say, nose. You can erase the top and do a heart shape.
Now, some people really like to do long, solid lines. I've always been kind of in awe of artists who do that, because all of mine are little short sketchy lines. I wonder if that has anything to do with like committing to the process or something. But
and you see this, it's kind of like, and then this, you erase, you could if you wanted to erase half of it and then draw two big bump bumps.
Two big bum bums. I'm sorry, they can't see that on the thing here. We got like, Lily's little shoppies in the background.
Like that.
Oh yeah, two big bum bums.
And then you put like a U under it.
Nope. Can't see it on.
Calculating.
You put like a U on it, under it, under the bum bumps, and then you color it in. Lily, what's special about the alpacas and the llamas' mouths and lips?
These two lips are actually separated, and they're literally overlapping the bottom lip. And they're
why?
Like, when they open their mouth, they're like,
what makes
like,
it special?
It's lips.
Yeah.
That's, maybe that's why they can spit so well.
You think so?
Yeah.
What do they do with their lips, though?
They eat with them.
They eat with them. They can, like, grab things with them.
No,
like, use
like,
them almost like fingers.
They're like, literally... three fingers going like that.
Now, you know, llamas have a snout, and so just adding a little bit of shading in this direction will help make it look longer, feel longer. And for me, on this one, it looks like to me the light source is probably coming from this side. It's a little bit lighter on this side, darker on this side. On this one that I sketched imagining, well, it's kind of hard to tell in the sketch, but imagining that there's more light coming from this side, and then I would paint in the darker shades on this side. So I'm gonna shade a little bit darker here just to bring in a little bit of depth.
Mine looks like a person, my nostril looks like a person's face.
Your nostril looks like a person's face.
Look, here are the eyes, and then here's like the nose, and here's the mouth.
Ah! Oh, and it's like singing, it's like a Muppet. That's what it reminds me of, it's kind of like a Muppet. So, and I'm just gonna bring a little, add a little more shape and dimension to this guy. They've got kind of furry, fuzzy faces. That's one reason I like that we chose doing the alpaca. Did we already say why we chose this? Because I suggested doing a cactus or a group of cacti because of your class, you know, and your teachers like cacti. And Lily said, Mom, we've already done that. That's in class.
And I said, we shall do llama or alpaca or whatever, I don't know.
Yeah, so we decided to do this. And we found one also that had like a
literal cactuses on its head.
Yeah, like a bouquet of cactuses in its head, so as like a crown. I don't know if I'm going to do that, but we'll see. Now, you can see this kind of coming together a little bit, maybe, maybe not. And then its neck is just super easy. You know, you can just add a little tufts of fur if you want it to be curly, soft fur, or kind of crazy jaggedy fur. It's up to you.
You're so pretty.
What are some things that llamas are used for? Do you know?
Probably riding or something.
Yeah.
Decorating.
Pack animals.
And they like carry stuff.
Yeah. They're a little more domesticated generally. They use their fur or hair, I guess. I don't know what they technically call it, but they make yarn. Really soft, strong thread with it. And these are kind of looking like horns. Maybe I should do something with the ears.
Maleficent. It's
Maleficent. Alpaca Maleficent. Llama Maleficent.
Llama Maleficent.
So they've got little hairs going up on the outside. And then on the inside, this is going to be the dark inside of their ears, you know. So you can draw that a little bit darker. In there, but they'll have, you know, some hairs. Even to here, so it's gonna be a little bit of hair. You can see that.
You know, even if you're a boy or a girl, you could add anything to this. You could add anything in the background, anything on top of its head. You could add a flower on its head. You don't have to draw eyelashes, even though there's eyelashes on the picture.
Well,
it's your drawing.
It is your drawing. You can make it however you want. You can make him like have dreadlocks if you wanted. Couldn't you?
You can make him have those.
If you're into that.
You can make him have braided hair and it just goes everywhere.
You can do whatever you want. I don't like these. Oh, here we go. That's what I'm missing. There needs to be a little
bow tie on
him.
You can put a bow tie on him.
A bow tie on him. Just kind of missing that curve. There we go. That's a little bit better. I'm sketching this a little more quickly than I did the first time around, just for the sake of the video. It still kind of looks like horns, doesn't it, a little bit? But we're working on it.
What does mine look like right now?
What do you think it looks a little bit like, Lily? It looks pretty good.
It actually, I think it looks like...
It just looks like it's peeking. Okay. So, the eyes, they have big, beautiful eyes, and they have naturally very, very long eyelashes. Do you know why they generally have long eyelashes?
I have no idea.
Camels also have really long eyelashes. Can you guess why they would have really long eyelashes?
No.
No?
No.
To help keep the sand out of their eyes. That's what camels...
Oh, I've heard that before.
...generally have them for. Alpacas? I suppose similar. Maybe you guys should look that up and study that for science, huh? They have big, beautiful eyes. Dark eyes. Which are quite hidden generally by their
eyelashes.
And fur. But you can just kind of sketch it in there. A lot of the times if I'm doing a painting though, I'll paint kind of a background in first, but you can paint a background in later. And if I know I'm gonna also be painting something, like I think I'll probably paint this as well, I'll leave a little bit of detail out in my sketching. I just kind of get a sketch going and then I'll paint it in better later. So, you see it coming together?
Can you see mine?
Oh yeah, look at that. Lily added glasses to hers. That's so fun. I'm tempted to add like flowers or something. Lily's using some watercolor markers, but generally if you use watercolors, you get the paper wet a little bit first, and but you can do it afterwards too and see how things blend and move.
I need to put more water in this.
So I've added
more shading and dimension to mine. And then I suppose I'll go ahead and paint it. I can do an example of a real simple one also, I guess. There's my really fast sketch.
Oh my gosh, it looks so cute. Should have made it angry.
So, this one took me a lot longer. One I did really, really quickly. Either way, they're fun. And I get a different feeling for both of them of how I might color them and paint them.
I'm finding treasures. He's making diamonds, diamonds, making diamonds out of dust. He is refining, and in his timing, he's making diamonds out of us. I'll surrender.
Diamonds out of dust.
out of us. Here and now.
The joy of the Lord, it will be my strength. When the pressure is on, he's making diamonds. Oh, the joy of the Lord, it will be my strength. When the pressure is on, he's making diamonds. Oh, the joy of the Lord, it will be my strength. When the pressure is on, he's making diamonds, diamonds.
Yeah. strength. When the pressure is on, he's making diamonds. Oh, the joy of the Lord, it will be my strength. When the pressure is on, he's making diamonds. Oh, the joy of the Lord, it will be my strength. When the pressure is on, he's making diamonds, diamonds.
Making time.